Very good morning to all of you. Today I am going to start with the next chapter, that is chapter number 13, Skin, the Jack of All Trades. So before starting with the chapter, I would like to discuss the various objectives of the chapter, which includes skin, integumentary system, various parts of integumentary system. So the various parts of integumentary system are skin proper and skin derivatives. We will discuss skin proper in detail. Skin proper is further subdivided into epidermis and dermis. Then skin derivatives. Skin derivatives are further subdivided into hair, cutaneous glands and nails. Then we will learn here in detail. Then we will also learn about cutaneous glands in detail. Cutaneous glands includes sweat glands, sebaceous glands and mammary glands. Then we will also learn about nails in detail. So children, let's start with the chapter skin. So kindly open up your books at page number 12.11. We are having five sense organs. These are eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. We know skin covers all the organs of the body. So, skin is the master sense organ. So, a question can be asked, why skin is the master organ of the body? Skin is called the master organ of the body as it protects our body from external injuries. Means its first function is to provide protection. Secondly, all the activities like from the transport of oxygen to the removal of carbon dioxide, all the activities they occurs inside the skin. So skin is the master organ of the body. So this question is quite important. It can be asked in reasoning also. So note it on your copies. Next is skin regulates the body temperature. It helps in excretion. It helps in perceiving the external stimulus. So we will discuss all these functions later in this chapter. So now children, integumentary system. What is integumentary system? Integumentary system is everything covering the outside of an animal body or organism. Here I am using word animal body or organism. It means skin, hair, scales, nails and sweat glands. They all together form integumentary system of an animal body or an organism. Here I have mentioned scales. Reason being I am talking about animals or organism. But if I will talk about human body. In case of human beings, no scales are there. So, integumentary system of human being consists of skin, hair, nails and sweat glands. So, now children, integumentary system. Integumentary system consists of two parts, skin proper and skin derivatives. So we will discuss skin proper in detail, then afterwards we will discuss skin derivatives in detail. So let's start with the skin proper. Skin proper is further divided into epidermis and dermis. Another name of dermis is corium or cutis vera. Below the dermis is a layer of loose connective tissues called subcutaneous layer or subcutaneous tissues. It attaches the skin to underlying organs. The function of subcutaneous layer is to attach the skin to underlying organs. And the epidermis and dermis fits into each other by a system of ridges and grooves. Now children, look at this diagram. This diagram is clearly showing the layers of the skin. Epidermis, dermis and subcutaneous layer. Now see very carefully. Epidermis and dermis. They are closely fit with each other with the help of these ridges and grooves. Now children see. Suppose These are ridges and grooves of epidermis. And these are ridges and grooves of dermis. So these ridges and grooves, the ridges and grooves of epidermis, they are very closely fit with the ridges and grooves of dermis. So due to this, they are totally interlocked with each other. So they are very closely fit together. So this is the connection amongst epidermis and dermis. So epidermis and dermis, they are closely fit together with the help of these ridges and grooves. So now children, look in the book at page number 13.1. Epidermis, it is the outer non-vascular and thin region of the skin. Here is the word non-vascular. So now children, vascular word, this only vascular word is for conducting tissue, and the main conducting tissue is blood, and the epidermis lack blood supply. How? Only the dermis contains blood vessels and nerve endings. I'll show you in the diagram also. Look here. Look at page number 13.2, figure 13.1. This diagram, vertical section of skin, is very clear over here. So children, it is very clear in this diagram that the epidermis and dermis portion are there. Only in dermis portion the blood vessels are available. These all are blood vessels. These are nerve fibers. So only in dermis part the blood vessels are there. In epidermis no blood vessel is there. So if no blood vessels are there, means no supply of blood is there. So that's why epidermis is non-vascular. And also it is made up of stratified epithelium. The word stratified. Stratified means several layered, means many layers are there. So again look at the same diagram. This is the epidermis part, and so many layers are there in epidermis. We are going to discuss all these layers in detail now. Children, epidermis is thick in palms and sole. Its thickness varies in different parts, and it is thickest in palms and soles. Different layer of epidermis are stratum corneum, stratum lucidum, stratum granulosum, stratum spinosum, and stratum basale. To learn these layers in sequential order, we can use a shortcut CLGSB. C for corneum, L for lucidum, G for granulosum, S for spinosum, and B for basale. Means CLGSB, CLGSB. So we can learn from this the sequence of the different layers of epidermis. Firstly, we will talk about stratum basale. Stratum basale is also known as stratum germinativum. It consists of single layer of columnar and highly cuboidal cells. And it rests upon the basement membrane, which is secreted by underlying dermis. The cells of this layer divides actively, and the new cells produced are pushed outward where flattening of cells takes place. Now look here children. This diagram is showing all the five layers of epidermis. So now look here. I am talking about stratum basale. Stratum basale consists of actively dividing cells. These cells are nourished by the blood vessels present in the dermis. I have shown you in the book also that only the dermis part is richly supplied with the blood vessels. It contains so many blood vessels. So the stratum basale, as it is very close to the dermis, it rests upon the basement membrane secreted by the underlying dermis. The actively dividing cells of this stratum basale layer, they get blood supply from the dermis. They get their nourishment, their blood supply from the dermis only. So the cells of this layer, they divide actively, and the new cells, they are pushed outward, where flattening of cells, it takes place. Now children, next layer is stratum spinosum. Stratum spinosum is composed of polygonal cells, and stratum basale and stratum spinosum, these two layers, they collectively called stratum malpighiae. So both these layers, stratum spinosum, stratum basale, they together called stratum malpighiae. So next layer is stratum granulosum. So children, stratum granulosum, it consists of 2 to 5 rows of rhomboid cells, and the cells of this layer contains a large number of keratohyaline granules that are very deeply stained. Children, these keratohyaline granules, they further leads to the formation of keratin, which we are going to discuss now only. So these keratohyaline granules, they get converted into keratin with the help of elagen, which is secreted by stratum lucidum. So now gradually the clear nucleus, which start disappearing in the outer layers of granulosum. So children, look at the diagram again. Here above stratum spinosum, a clear view is there of stratum granulosum. Children, the cells of stratum granulosum layer, they have a grainy appearance. They have grainy appearance. So that's why their name is granulosum. And also the cells of this layer, they begin to die. Why? Why they begin to die? Because they are now very far from the nutrient source. See, this is dermis portion. So they are very far from the nutrient source. Blood supply is still the stratum basale. So after that, in epidermis, no blood supply is there. So the nutrient source is very far away. So that's why the cells, they begin to die. Next is stratum lucidum. Stratum lucidum is a very thin layer. You are able to see in this diagram also. It is a very thin layer and is present above the granulosum. Children, this layer is identifiable only in the regions where epidermis is thick. In others, where epidermis is thin, it is not identifiable. Now, the cytoplasm of these cells contain a reflective substance called elagen. Now this elagen is an intermediate compound which changes keratohyaline to keratin, which I have discussed right now. So keratohyaline that was there, that is there in stratum granulosum, it get converted into keratin due to intermediate compound that is called elagen. So elagen is produced in the layer called stratum lucidum. In this diagram also, these are dead and very thin layer of cells called stratum lucidum. Now next to the stratum lucidum, the topmost layer of epidermis is stratum corneum. Now the stratum corneum is composed of clear dead scale like cells which become more and more flattened as they move towards the surface. So here you can see very clearly that the outermost layer, stratum cornea, the cells, they are dead clear and scale like. They are very 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 flat. The nuclei of the cells have already disappeared, and the cytoplasm of these cells is replaced by insoluble protein called keratin. So this outer layer of dead keratinized cells is called stratum corneum. So children, keratin is a waterproof material. During our lifetime, we shed about 23 kgs of skin. As stratum corneum, it casts off as small pieces at intervals. So in our lifetime, during our lifetime, we shed about 23 kilograms of skin in the same manner. Now children, the rate at which the cells of stratum corneum they cast off is same at which the new cells are formed by the stratum bacilli, and this keeps the thickness of epidermis constant. Means more new cells are produced, more cells, more dead cells they will cast off. So children, now look here.
So now children, look at this model. To make concept more clear, I have made a model for you people. So in this model, all the layers, they are very clear. Now look very carefully. This upper portion till this is called epidermis. We have studied now. This lower portion, this is called dermis. And this last yellow colored layer is the layer of subcutaneous tissue, and the layer is called subcutaneous layer. Now here, first layer is stratum corneum, then stratum lucidum, stratum granulosum, stratum spinosum, and stratum bacilli layer. Now children, see the stratum bacilli layer, as we have already discussed, is rest upon the basement membrane of epidermis, and from the dermis, which is richly supplied with the blood vessels. Now children, here blood vessels, they are indicated by blue and red lines. So it is getting blood supply from there only. So these all are blue and red colored. These are blood vessels. So these are available only in dermis part. So stratum bacilli, as it lies just at the basement membrane of the dermis, means it is lying just next to the dermis. So it is getting the blood supply from this dermis only. As the cells, they are pushed upward, upward and upward, the supply of blood as well as the supply of nutrients becomes negligible. So the cells, they start dying, and ultimately the cells, when they reach to stratum granulosum, they are dead cells, and finally they cast off. So children, this black colored portion, this is hair shaft. We'll discuss this in later in this chapter. Then these are red colored thread like structure. These are erector pili muscles. These erector pili muscles, they results in contraction of here when we feel cold, when we feel threat, and in some other sort of situations. Means erector pili muscles results in contraction of hairs. Otherwise, normally we know at the surface of our skin, the hairs, they are just slantingly they keep on the surface of the skin. But when we feel cold, when we feel threat, suddenly our hairs, they get straight. So why they get straight? They get straight due to contraction of these erector pili muscles only. So these green lines, they are indicating the nerve endings and nerve fibers. See, these all are nerve fibers and nerve endings. This is sebaceous gland. Children, this sebaceous gland, it opens into hair follicle. Its function is to lubricate the hair and make it oily and waterproof. We feel that sometimes our skin, it becomes oily, and that oily secretions are due to these sebaceous glands only. Now children, see, there is sweat gland also. This is sweat gland, and this is sweat duct, which opens at the surface of epidermis. So the function of sweat gland is to secrete sweat, is to produce sweat. And the next is the subcutaneous tissue and subcutaneous layer. This subcutaneous layer stores the excess fat, means the excess of the body fats are deposited here, and it insulates the body against cold and heat, and also it acts as a shock absorber. And children, see, these blood vessels here, they divide, they bifurcate into blood capillaries. And look here, so children, this is all about the VS of skin. We will discuss all other parts also in detail. And children, kindly do all the question answers related to the topic, mark them on the book. Write reasoning questions on the copy and write terms on the copies also. So stay at home, study well. We'll continue the next topic in the next lecture. Thank you so much.